हाय स्टूडेंट्स, इंटरमीडिएट सेकंड ईयर इंग्लिश मीडियम वी आर डिस्कसिंग द फर्स्ट यूनिट. सो इन द फर्स्ट यूनिट सो मेनी टॉपिक्स वर कंप्लीटेड बाय द प्रीवियस क्लासेस एंड टुडे इन दिस वीडियो आई एम गोइंग टू एनालाइज द व्हाट आर द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक फीचर्स ऑफ डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज. व्हाट आर द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक फीचर्स ऑफ डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज. First of all, let me say the countries about a few words here. The world economy is, or the globe is, the world economy is divided into three categories actually. In the three categories, developed countries, developing countries, underdeveloped countries. Okay, once again, developed countries, developing countries, underdeveloped countries. Here, the underdeveloped countries' aim is to developing. So, no need to separate information or discussion of underdeveloped countries. That's why basically the world countries are divided into two categories. One is developed countries. Second one is developing countries. So, developed countries. So, this is question in this. For this academic year due to the coronavirus, so it is a deletion topic. And today in this video I am going to analyze the characteristics of developing countries or developing economies. Economy is nothing but the country. What are the characteristics of developing economy? What are the features are there just like? What are the features and characteristics of developing economy? Let me analyze one by one here. See, characteristics of developing countries, special reference to India. What is the special reference to India? India is the developing economy. So the characteristics which we are going to analyze, that is applicable to India, special reference to India. What I want to analyze, that is applicable to India. So this is special reference to India, characteristics of developing countries. See here. Let me analyze one. Low per capita income. Yes, we are in the low per capita income. It is only why means our Indian people per capita income is very low. Income levels is very low. And the low per capita income when we compare to the developed countries, in those countries, so their per capita income is very high. Why? Their national income increases. How can we get the per capita income? National income by total population. When we divided their national income by total population, we get the per capita income. But the getting per capita income is very low due to we are getting the developing economies. How can we say that India is a developing economy? What are the proofs are there? So this is the first proof. Means only low per capita income, low level of income. The peoples are getting the low level of income. And most of the peoples are, they have no job opportunities, they are in the unemployment position. So overall the economy is underdeveloping or developing stage. It is a low per capita income, which is the first feature to prove the India as a developing economy. Low per capita income. Then second, predominance of agriculture. What is the predominance? The most of the peoples are depends on agriculture. Three sectors are there: agriculture, industrial, service sector. But the most of the people, nearly the total population of the country, out of total population, nearly 56% of people depends on still now on the agricultural sector. Nearly half of total population of the country depends on agriculture. There is a predominance of agriculture, but in those developed countries, most of the peoples are depends on industrial and the service sector. The less percentage of peoples depends on agriculture. It is a predominance of agriculture. You know, the developed countries, it is only 2-5% of people depends on agriculture. In these countries, with a special reference to India, the people depends on agriculture is nearly 50% people. So there is a predominance of agriculture. So the people who are depends on agriculture, there should be migrate to the industrial and the service sector. when these peoples are migrate to service and industrial sector, then the economic development will be increases. So due to predominance of agriculture, we are in the developing stage. Then capital deficiency, yes, I said number of times, capital deficiency. What is the capital deficiency? Income of the people very low. When the income low is, saving is very low, capital is very low, and investment is very low. The capital formation is very low, deficiency low. What is the deficiency? The investment is needs to 100%, but the capital formation is only 9-10% of capital formation is there. The remaining is 90% deficit. We require the 100% of investment to establishment of industrial service sector, economy development, but the saving is only the 10%. How? The 90% of income is borrow the funds from various sources. So here there is a capital deficiency. How, sir? How can we increase the capital formation? By increasing the income of the people. When the income increases, automatically saving increases. Saving increases, the capital formation increases. Capital formation increases, the investment will be also increases. So there is available to huge capital, huge investment. The huge investment is useful to the establishment of number of industries, expansion of economic growth rate, expansion of service and the agriculture sector. So it is a major causes of developing countries are capital deficiency, low capital. Then technological backwardness, yes, we are in the technological backwardness. We are using the older machineries, older equipments, old machineries, older methods. And how can we get the more productivity? When we use the technology in the process of the production, we get the more production. But technological backwardness, we are in the manually, we can get productivity. Not machine, not you can use the machineries, not technology in the process of the production. So technologically we are backwardness due to we are in the developing stage. Then inadequate infrastructure, yes, infrastructure facilities are very low. No health facilities, no education facilities, no road facilities, no supporting price facilities, no communication facilities. So all infrastructures are very low. Inadequate means very low. Inadequate infrastructure facilities. There is no credit facilities to the farmers. There is no credit facilities to the industrialist. How can they improve the productivity in various sectors? If they want to increase the industrial product, they need to the investment. But who give the investment to the industrialist? The banks are refuse to loan to the industrialist. But how can they increase? So here, inadequate infrastructure, no proper education facilities, no proper health facilities, no communication facilities, no electricity facilities. If available are there in our country, but it is inadequate, not proper. It is inadequate infrastructure facilities are there due to we are getting low productivity. So we can say India is a developing economy. Next to demographic features. Demography is the main cause. There is a heavy population pressure. Year by year the population increases. Nearly 1.2% of growth rate is there in India. We are occupied the second place in the world. With a demographic feature, we are in the second stage. Means so population explosion. But how the government provide more and more employment opportunities, but growing population? Already unemployment is there. But year by year the population increases. But who provides the more employment opportunities? It is so difficult to provision. So it is also one of the cause. Means so developing country, India is a developing country because of demographic features, heavy population pressure, birth rate is very high, mortality rate is very high. Okay, but when we come back to the developed countries, their birth rate is very low and the death rate is also very low. But here birth rate is very high, death rate is very low. Due to we are suffering with so many infrastructure facilities, so many facilities, they are competitive with them. Among the total population of the country, no more facilities are provided. So the government is also, how can they provide more and more facilities to all the total population of the country? No, it is not possible. Why? Because heavy population pressure, then high rate of illiteracy. This is also one of the cause. Illiteracy. Most of the people are living in the rural areas. The people who are living in the rural areas, they are illiteracy. They have no knowledge how to get the more productivity in agriculture sector. And there is no crop holiday. Then there is no crop rotation method. And there is no awareness how to increase the more productivity in agriculture. Why? Because they are illiteracy. They have no facilities. Okay. So, high rate of illiteracy due to we are getting the low productivity in various sectors. Not only agriculture, the industrial peoples are also illiteracy. They are only the traditional method they are using. For example, small scale industries are there, you know. Their establishment are in rural areas. Handloom industries are there. And sugar industries are there. And handicrafts industries are there. How they following? Old machineries, older equipments, traditional methods. But how can they increase the more productivity by using them without sophisticated technology? It's too difficult. So, high rate of illiteracy due to the economy is getting the low level of income. We are in the developing stage. Then, dualistic economy. What is the dualistic economy? You know, out of 100% of total population, nearly 50% of people are illiteracy. But census is there, census is different. But here, 50% of illiteracy persons. The 50% of illiteracy persons are using the, old methods. They are using the old methods. One hand. Another hand is, the out of 100, the remaining 50%, for example, this is 60. This is 40. Too easy to calculate. The 60% of illiteracy persons, they are using the old machineries, old methods. The 40%, they can use the technology, technical progress. The 40% of peoples, they are producing the production with the use of the technical progress. And the 60% of people, they can use the old methods. Dual system is there. Try to understand. Dual system. What is the dual system? Modern technology production methods are there and old methods are there, including a single economy. The literacy people, they can use the technical progress technologically, and the remaining people they are using the old methods, means dual system, dual economy. This is the dualistic economy. Then, underdeveloped natural resources. We have plenty of natural resources. India is not poor, but Indians are poor. Plenty of natural resources are there. Air is there, sunlight is there, water is there, and minerals are there. And so many natural resources are available in the nature. But there is no proper scientific way, proper utilization of how to get more benefits from the natural resources. And there is no scientific survey how to utilize, how to optimum utilization of natural resources. Due to we are in the developing stage. You know, developed countries, they can proper utilization of a solar system. They can proper utilization of natural resources, proper utilization of water, air. Then they can get fruitful results from the natural resources through economic development. But here, due to the lack of technical progress, no knowledge about the technical progress, how to optimal utilization of natural resources, we are in the economic development. This is under developed natural resources and lack of entrepreneurship. Yes, entrepreneurs are very low. Investors are very low. How can the investors, if the income increases, automatically saving increases, capital increases, investment increases. When the invest increases, investors will also increase. Like double levandi, pettubadi pette vallu. Entrepreneurs ante. Agriculture development చేసేవాళ్ళు, industry development చేసేవాళ్ళు, కొత్త కొత్త industry start చేసేవాళ్ళు, economy develop చేసేవాళ్ళు, వీళ్ళంతా entrepreneurs అంట. మరి వీళ్ళ దగ్గర డబ్బులే లేవు, ఇన్వెస్ట్మెంట్ కావాలి కదా. మరి ఇన్వెస్ట్మెంట్ కావాలంటే వాళ్ళ ఇన్కమ్ ఎలా ఉండాలి? ఎక్కువ ఉండాలి. కానీ ఇక్కడ ఎక్కువ లేదే. ఎలా అంటే ల్యాక్ ఆఫ్ ఎంటర్ప్రెన్యూవర్షిప్. పెట్టుబడి పెట్టే వాళ్ళు తక్కువ ఉన్నారు. దెన్ అన్ఎంప్లాయ్మెంట్, డిస్గైజ్డ్ అన్ఎంప్లాయ్మెంట్. ఎస్, దెర్ ఇస్ ఎ ఓపెన్ అన్ఎంప్లాయ్మెంట్ ఇస్ దేర్. year by year the population increases. When the population increases, the labor force is competitive with others. Okay, and if people are getting the job opportunities, the remaining are not getting the job opportunities, they fell into the poverty. This is the unemployment position. The people who are able to work at the prevailing wage rate, they have not get the job opportunities called unemployment. This is open unemployment. And disguised unemployment. The disguised unemployment mostly we can see in the agriculture sector. Means the people who are more than required in agriculture sector. More than required. For example, here 1000 acres of land is there, for example. 1000 acres of land. But only the 2% of people are enough to cultivate the agriculture. But here 56% of people depends on agriculture. Enough is only 2. But here is 56%. Means more than required. This is called a disguised unemployment. But okay sir, the people are only disguised unemployment. What about the remaining? తీసేసి వేరే సెక్టార్ పంపించవచ్చు కదా అవసరం ఉన్న వాళ్ళని. మీన్స్ దెర్ ఇస్ నో ఎంప్లాయ్మెంట్ ఆపర్చునిటీస్ ఇండస్ట్రియల్ అండ్ సర్వీస్ సెక్టార్. యాజ్ ఎ రిజల్ట్ దే ఆర్ డిపెండ్స్ ఆన్ అగ్రికల్చర్ సెక్టార్. నెక్స్ట్ సోషల్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్స్. ఎస్, ట్రెడిషన్స్ ఆర్ దేర్, క్యాస్టిజమ్స్ ఆర్ దేర్ అండ్ సబ్ క్యాస్ట్స్ ఆర్ దేర్ అండ్ సోషల్ సెరమనీస్ ఆర్ దేర్ అండ్ సైకాలజీ ఆఫ్ ద పీపుల్, యాటిట్యూడ్ ఆఫ్ ద పీపుల్, ఓల్డ్ మెథడ్స్ ఆఫ్ ద పీపుల్, ఇల్లిటరసీ ఆఫ్ ద పీపుల్ and old approaches of the people. So these are all the caused by the developing countries with special reference to India social institutions. Then foreign trade orientation. Yes, what is the foreign trade orientation? So we are exporting the only the foreign agricultural goods, primary goods, and we have to improve the agricultural export, the industrial export and service sector export. But when we increase the industrial service sector import, means when we expansion of industrial, when we expansion of service sector, then we it is a possible to export the industrial the service sector. But there is no expansion of industrial and service sector, only the basic primary goods are we are exporting to foreign countries. So we are not getting the sufficient foreign exchange by exporting the goods and services. Due to only we are exporting the primary goods. Means foreign trade orientation to be made. We have to increase more and more production, more and more establishment of number of industries in agriculture, industrial, service sector. Then it is possible to foreign trade. Then we can get the foreign income. Okay. So these are the proofs of the characteristics of developing country with a special reference to India. Okay, so this is the way of the presentation of the characteristics of developing country. Okay, thank you very much.